Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. I want to begin the program today with a hymn by none other than Charles Wesley. The year was 1739. Now, it is said that Wesley wrote this hymn to commemorate the first anniversary of his conversion to Christ. What do you suppose the hymn is called? The music, by the way, is by Lowell Mason. Well, the hymn is called "Oh, for a Thousand Tongues to Sing."
Oh,
Annie S. Hawks, in the year 1871, composed the words to the hymn, I Need Thee Every Hour. She passed the words on to her minister, Robert Lowry, who composed the music. I trust that you will enjoy I Need Thee Every Hour. The word saint is not widely used in our vocabulary today, except when it refers to some of the great saints that were canonized by the Catholic Church. But we believe within the Protestant tradition that the word saint simply means one of Christ's faithful followers. So the members in the early church would often refer to one another as a saint. With that thought in mind, I want to share with you the hymn called When the Saints Go Marching In. That's, of course, when the believers in Christ go marching in. And if you're a believer in Jesus Christ, you're a saint.
I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, ye may be also. And there shall be no night there, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away.
Be in that
That was the late Dr. James Kennedy of Coral Ridge Presbyterian Church in Fort Lauderdale there, introducing the well-known hymn, When the Saints Go Marching In. Now, let me tell you a little bit about our next hymn. The words are attributed to Dorothy A. Thrupp. The year was 1836. The music was by William B. Bradbury. And the hymn is, Savior, Like a Shepherd Lead Us. Augustus Toplady, date 1740-1778. He was born in Farnham, Surrey, in England. He attended Westminster School, London, and Trinity College in Dublin. He was ordained an Anglican priest in 1762 and served as curate at Blagdon and Farley. In 1766, he became vicar of Broadhembury in Devonshire. He left the Anglican Church, though, in 1775, moved to London, and began preaching at the French Calvinist Church there. He authored the hymn, Rock of Ages.
Save for God.
Some hymns, for some reason, tend to be associated with funeral services, but they're beautiful hymns in themselves with a tremendous theology behind them. One of those hymns is Abide With Me. The author of that hymn was Henry F. Light, and the hymn was composed in the year by Light in 1847. Enjoy Abide With Me.
Abide with me, fast falls the eventide, the darkness deepens, Lord, with me abide. When other helpers fail and comforts
of Dear Lord and Father of Mankind were composed by John G. Whittier. The year was 1872. These words are from a long narrative poem called The Brewing of Soma. It describes Vedic priests going into the forest and drinking themselves into a stupor with a concoction called Soma. They try to have a religious experience and contact the spirit world. It is after setting that scene that Whittier draws his lesson, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, forgive our foolish ways. It has been said by others that the hymn is relevant today as when it was written. In a modern context, it speaks to the drug culture and those looking for an experience to prove the reality of God. Dear Lord and Father of Mankind.
Thank you.
We're going to close our program today, folks, with a prayer. It's a prayer that is sung. You know it as the Lord's Prayer. You also know the story, hopefully, behind it, how the disciples one day went to Jesus and they said, Lord, would you teach us how to pray? Just think about it for a moment. They could have asked Jesus for anything. Teach us how to walk on water. Teach us, Lord, how to raise the dead. Teach us how to feed 10,000 people with a little bit of bread and a few fish. But no, instead they said, Lord, teach us how to pray. And Jesus taught them the prayer that's come down to be known as the Lord's Prayer. It can be a prayer unto itself, but it's also acts as a model, or should act as a model, for all our prayers. Hear now the Lord's Prayer. It was great to have you with us today, folks, and I hope that you will join us again for yet more of Great Hymns of the Faith, and perhaps invite a friend to listen in as well. And as I've mentioned before in the program, if you would like to hear a favorite hymn, you haven't heard it for a while, you wonder if I have it in my library, why not drop me a note and let me know? And I will do my very best to retrieve that hymn for you. So please, if you have access to email, my email address is doulos, doulosreve @gmail.com. Or you can still use the regular post. It's Pastor John Fraser, 4072 Rivercrest Circle, Leesburg, Leesburg, Florida. And the zip code is 34748. So drop us a note, let us know what your favorite hymn is, and as I say, I will look through my library, and hopefully I will find it, and I will play it for you. Until we meet again, folks, God bless.